Dear students, in last class we studied the capacitance of single phase transmission line. Today we have to take up the capacitance of three phase transmission line with conductors placed unsymmetrically and symmetrically. But before we go for it, we will see what is transposition of transmission line conductors. Transposing of power conductors means changing the position of phase conductors at regular interval along the line. So that each conductor occupy others' positions over an equal distance. As shown, in figure below, let us say these are the positions of three conductors, namely A, C and B. Initially, the positions of these three conductors may be shown like this. Along its root, A conductor at the top, C conductor in between, and B conductor at the bottom. After, say, 1/3 of total length of line, conductor A goes to position of conductor C. Conductor C goes to position of conductor B. and conductor B goes to position of conductor A. So now we are having here B, here conductor A, and here conductor C. Again, after one third of the total length of line, conductor A goes to position of conductor C. Conductor C goes to position of conductor B. And conductor B goes to position of conductor A. So now we are having here conductor C, here B, and here A. So now the first position is here for one third length of transmission line. For next one third length of transmission line, position 2 we are having, and for the last one third length of transmission line we are having position 3. This is nothing but transposition of transmission line or line conductors or power conductors. If transmission lines are not transposed, the voltage drop in transmission line will not be the same due to unequal inductances. And capacitances. Another problem is the radio interference. Because external flux outside the conductors is not zero. Now we'll take potential difference between two conductors in A. Group of conductors. Figure below shows a group of n parallel conductors. The first conductor is here. Second conductor is here. Third conductor is here. Like that, fourth conductor is here. And nth conductor is here. First conductor, second conductor, third conductor, fourth conductor, and nth conductor. The distance between first and second conductor, the distance between first and second conductors is D12. Similarly, the distance between first and fourth conductor is D14. Distance between first and nth conductor is D1N. Distance between first and third conductor is D13. Similarly, we can have the distances between all the conductors. Distance between fourth conductor and third conductor is say D34, and so on. Let us assume that the sum of their charges is zero. The distance between any two conductor, the distance between any two conductors is much larger than radius of conductor. And the effect of ground is negligible. The charges are also uniformly distributed. On the surface of and the length the potential difference between conductors one and two due to charge Q1 on conductor one is given by V12 equal to Q1 upon 2π ε0 ln of D12 by R1 volts. Where D12 is the distance between conductor 1 and conductor 2 conductor 1 and conductor 2 and R1 is the radius of conductor 1. The potential difference between conductor 2 and conductor 1 due to the charge on the conductor 2, Q2 is V12 equal to Q2 by 2π ε0 ln of R2 by D12 volts. If the distance between conductor 3 and conductor 1 is D13. And between conductor 3 and conductor 2 is D23. The potential difference between conductors one and two due to the charge Q3 on conductor 3 is V12 equal to Q3 upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln of D23 by D13 volts. Similarly, the voltage drop between here, voltage drop means potential difference. If there is no potential, if there is no voltage drop, if there is no voltage drop, then there will be no potential difference. Similarly, the voltage drop or potential difference between conductors one and two due to charge on all other conductors can be calculated the total potential difference between conductors one and two due to charges on all the conductors is V12 equal to Q1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln of D12 by R1 plus Q2 upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln of R2 by D12 plus Q3 by 2 pi epsilon naught ln of D23 by D13 plus and so on up to charge on nth conductor divided by 2 pi epsilon naught ln of D2n by D1n volts. Let us call this as equation 6. In similar ways, the potential difference between other conductors due to charges of all the conductors can also be calculated. Now we will take up capacitance of unsymmetrically spaced three-phase lines. If the line is not transposed, the capacitance between the line and neutral will not be equal. The capacitance of each phase 2 neutral of an untransposed line will be almost the same. The error is negligible. And the calculation becomes simpler. If there are no charges in the vicinity of the phases, the sum of the charges in phases will be equal to 0. With radius of each conductor equal to r, let us calculate the potential difference between phases A and B, that is VAB. For position 1, as shown in transposition of conductors diagram, let the potential difference between phases A and B be equal to VAB1. In position 1, as shown in transposition figure, due to charges on the conductors using equation 5, VAB1 is equal to QA, that is charge on conductor A, by 2 pi epsilon naught ln of distance between conductor A and B, that is DAB, upon radius of conductor R, plus QB upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln of R upon DAB plus QC upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln of DBC upon DAC. Let us call this as now equation 6. In position 2, conductor A will take the position of conductor B and conductor B will take the position of conductor C and so on. The potential difference between phases A and B, that is VAB2, in position 2 will be VAB2 is equal to QA upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln of DAB by R plus QB upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln of R by DBC plus QC upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln DAC upon DAB. Please note here, as the position of conductors change, the distances will change. Therefore, we have to take the corresponding distances in these ratios. Similarly, the potential difference between phases A and B, VAB3 in position 3 will be VAB3 is equal to QA upon 2 pi epsilon naught ln of DAC upon R plus QB upon 2 pi epsilon naught into ln of R by DAC plus QC upon 2 pi epsilon naught into ln of DAB by DBC. The average potential difference between phases A and B will be VAB is equal to VAB1 plus VAB2 plus VAB3 upon 3. That is equal to 1 by 3 by 2 pi epsilon naught into the bracket QA will make use of laws of logarithms here. DAB into DBC into DAC upon R cube plus QB into ln of R cube by DAB into DBC into DAC plus QC into ln of DAB into DBC into DAC by DAB into DBC into DAC. Simplifying, we get one by two pi epsilon naught into the bracket QA into ln of DEQ by R plus QB into ln of R upon DEQ. Where DEQ is equal to DAB into DBC into DCA or DAC into DAC raised to 1 by 3. Similarly, VAC is equal to one upon two pi epsilon naught QA into ln of DEQ by R plus QC into ln of R by DEQ. Since we have considered transposed line the line voltages will be equal. Now we will draw the phasor diagram for the line voltages. Say A is here. C is here. And B is here. The neutral of this three-phase system will be at the center of this triangle obtained now. So we'll write here N. Voltage here is VAC, here it is VAB. Now we will add VAB and VAC. To do that, I will take this VAC phasor and place it at A. Now, this is also equal to VAC. Joining the tips here, we get sum of VAC and VAB. Let us say this point is D. So VBD is equal to VAC plus VAB. Since VAC and VAB are equal, triangle ABD is isosceles triangle. If I draw a median, it will be perpendicular to base BD. Let us say median here is AE. Now point E will be the midpoint of BD. So it will bisect BD. In other words, we can say DE equal to BE. Now angle here is 60 degree. As we have taken all line voltages equal, ABC will be an equilateral triangle. Therefore, all the angles will be equal to 60 degree. Hence, the angle between AD and AE will also be equal to 60 degree. Since angle E is 90 degree, because in case of isosceles triangle, median and altitude are same. So 60 plus 90, 150, 180 minus 150, it will become 30 degree. So angle D is 30 degree. Hence we can write DE equal to VAC into cos 30. VAC into cos 30. Or we can write it as AD into cos 30. That is AD into root 3 by 2. Therefore, BD is equal to 2 times DE is equal to 2 into AD into root 3 by 2, that is equal to 3 times AD. Let us call the voltage here as VAN. That is, An is equal to VAN. If the magnitude of VAN is capital V, which is same for all the phases the magnitude of VAC and VAB will be root 3 times V, because line voltages are equal to root 3 times phase voltages. Therefore, substituting for AD equal to VAC equal to root 3 times V in equation for BD, we get BD equal to root 3 into root 3 V, that is equal to 3 times V. Since BD is in phase with VAN, that means both are parallel to each other here. Therefore, VAB plus VAC is equal to BD is equal to 3 times VAN. Let us call this as equation. We have to call equation for VAB as equation number 7 here. Please number this. Here you number it as 8. Now we can call the equation number 9. Using equation 7 and 8 in 9, that is VAB plus VAC equal to 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into the bracket QA into ln of DEQ by R plus QB into ln of R by DEQ plus 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into the bracket QA into ln of DEQ by R plus QC into ln of R by DEQ equal to taking 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught common outside, 2 times QA ln of DEQ by R plus QB plus QC into ln of R by DEQ. Here we have taken ln of R by DEQ common outside. We know that sum of charges is equal to 0. We can write QB plus QC equal to minus QA. Therefore, VAB plus VAC will become equal to 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into the bracket 2 times QA ln of DEQ by R plus minus QA into ln of R by DEQ. That is equal to, we will have here 2 pi epsilon naught into QA into ln of DEQ by R into 3, because simplifying we get 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught 3 times QA into ln into DEQ by R. Remember here, while using laws of logarithms, DEQ by R we are having, and here it is R by DEQ. If you reverse it, the sign will change. Then these two will get added, and hence you get here 3. Now let us call this as equation number 10. Using equation 9 and 10, we get three times VAN is equal to 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught 3 QA ln of DEQ by R. Cancelling 3 on both sides, we get VAN equal to 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into the bracket QA ln of DEQ by R. Making use of this, we will calculate phase to neutral capacitance. Thus, the capacitance of phase conductor A to neutral plane will be CAN is equal to QA upon VAN, that is equal to, using expression for VAN, we get 2 pi epsilon naught upon ln of DEQ by R farads per meter. Let us call this as equation 11. It can be seen that CBN and CCN will be equal to CAN. Dear students, I will stop the class here. I thank you for your patience.